some people say that this earth is of accidental creation. This universe is of accidental creation. An accident is the root cause of this creation. So accident is the God because it created the world. And so accident should be the object of ideation. It is also a foolish idea.
Sava esha tadadrastana pasya drishya mekarat mene santan vatmanam supta shakti rasutra dik. And this creation, what it is nothing but different portions of his divine body.
There cannot be more than one noumenal cause. The supreme noumenal entity is a singular one. So the conception of so many gods, so many goddesses, so many ghosts are all based on defective ideas. The supreme father, the noumenal entity, is a singular entity, and that noumenal entity is the loving father. One's relationship with the loving father is that of love and affection, is a domestic relationship. There is nothing formal or nothing sort of formality in it. The relationship is purely domestic, a family relationship. So the noumenal cause is not just a theoretical entity, it is your father, your dearest and nearest one. And one should not be afraid of God, one should not be God-fearing, one must be God-loving.
My Supreme Father, before the creation, my Supreme Father was alone in this universe. There was nothing. And for want of the quintal mental factors, there was nothing to see, nothing to do. He was alone. Suppose you are alone in a particular village or in a particular house. What will be your position? What will be your mental condition? It will be just like what? An insane person, a mad. So in this vast cosmos, my father was alone. Just try to feel what was his condition, what was his mental condition. So just to save himself from the monotony of singularity, he created this universe just to play with his children. This is the only reason. I know no other philosophy. This will be the reply of a devotee.
Then, who is your object of ideation? Who should be your object of ideation? Who is the faculty that creates you, feeds you, and takes you on his lap when the proper time comes? He is the cognitive force behind the cosmic energy. He controls the cosmic energy with his intellectual and intuitional power. He is the Paramapurusha. And actually, he is the causal matrix. And so, he should be your only object of ideation, only object of meditation, and he is the Supreme Father. There is no other alternative but to move along his path. He knoweth all. Be one with him. Now, from the very start of your life in distant past, and to up to the final culmination of all your movements and marches, you are with him. you will be with him, and under no circumstances you can be away from him. So he is the only object of ideation, that Paramapurusha. The root meaning of the term Baba is the dearest one or the nearest one. As he is the Supreme Father, the Paramapurusha, he is Baba of the entire creation. And because you are the created being, you are his loving children, you are also his Baba, because Baba means nearest and dearest one. As he is your only object of ideation, as his name is the only projection of your microcosmic entity, only thought projection, only introversal projection, intro cum extroversal projection. So his name should be always with you, in your mind, in your tongue, in your vocal cord, everywhere. And I feel, and I also realize, and that's why I say, when his devotees, his children sing Baba Nam Kevalam, he also sings Baba Nam Kevalam. Kalyan. Thank you.
before you so many human beings came. And Australopithecus in the old animal, which was the forefather of modern men, was in this world about 10 lakhs of years ago, 100,000 years ago. In Pliocene age, sometimes in Pliocene age, then Miocene, Oligocene, Mesozoic, this one is canon, I can go on and start as far as archaeology. Now, you know, quickly so many human beings came, and you are descendant of that human, those old human beings who came here and who left this world long ago. You are their descendants. So, Pitri Purusha, Bhyanama Pitri Purusha, mane all our forefathers who came in this world and left this world. So many people, so many billions of people came since last 10 lakhs of years. The Pitri Purushebhya Namaha. I do Namah to those people because I am a contiguity of those people in the flow of human race. Arashi Devabhya Namaha. During this long period, so many things were invented by so many great people. Those great people are known as Rishi. The man who invented penicillin is a Rishi. Who invented aeroplane, a Rishi. Motor car, a Rishi. Television, a Rishi. So many Rishis came. And those who invented bullock carts, they are also Rishis in those dark ages. In that dark age, the man who invented bullock cart was also a Rishi at that time. So many Rishis came, and in their age they were glittering personalities. We may or may not recognize them in this second half of 20th century, but in their ages they were glittering personalities. So Rishi Devaya Namaha, I do Namah for those Rishis also who invented so many things. And the collection of the inventions is the modern human civilization.